joining us next is Frank Rinn, who came all the way from Germany to show us some technology. So you've got some fancy way to figure out how much decay is in a tree. Can you talk to us about this? And you are also the inventor, I should say, right?
Yep, that's right. That's right.
So tell us what about, we got here.
About 35 years ago, I got the idea from someone presented that a needle could help us understanding trees. Mm-hmm. So he said, you should push a needle into the wood and measure the resistance against the penetration. It didn't work, his idea didn't work, so I developed a machine out of that. And that's the machine, we call it Resistograph. And it basically drills in a thin needle into wood, measures the resistance and delivers a profile that shows us the internal condition of the tree.
Okay, so is it measuring both the torque that you have to turn it as well as the actual insertion of that?
Oh yeah, very, very nice, yeah.
Okay.
It measures the whole work electrically that is necessary to put the needle into the wood.
Okay.
That means it measures the rotational and the thrust.
So how far do you go into the tree with something like
this? In this case, typically 20 inches.
Okay.
So, but we have a long machine with about 40 inches drilling depth.
Okay.
But for most urban trees, 20 inches is sufficient.
Okay, well, this seems like a very high-tech method. In what sort of application would we use something like this?
Actually, the biggest market for this is inspecting poles, utility poles.
Oh, really?
Because wooden utility poles typically deteriorate under below ground.
Right.
And with this machine, you can drill at the base of the pole, find out if there is decay below ground in that pole that might lead to a collapse of the pole.
Okay.
The second market is timber buildings. Worldwide, you know, there are millions of houses built with timber, mm-hmm. and timber deteriorates over time. And with this, you can check without really destroying the timber because the hole is so tiny, small, a tenth of an inch approximately, so that it's nearly non-destructive and we can find out if there is decay inside or if there are termites inside that eat up the wood.
Okay.
And then the next market is urban tree inspection, trees like that, standing here in parks or along roads, where this machine allows us to find out if there is internal decay that compromises the safety, the stability of the tree.
Okay, so it's not as simple as pulling the trigger though and just it tells you it's decayed or not.
That would be great.
Can you tell me kind of what it actually gives you as a printout and tells you?
Basically, it gives you a profile along the depth of the drilling that shows the density along the depth of the drilling.
Mm-hmm.
It reflects the tree rings in that density profile, and when the tree is decayed, then the profile drops down and shows, okay, there is deteriorated wood.
Okay, so where there's deteriorated wood, that means there's no resistance.
No resistance anymore. No mechanical resistance. And this is shown by these profiles. And the people working with it first have to understand the biomechanics of trees to know where to drill, then how to drill, that means how to operate the machine,
mm-hmm.
and then how to interpret the profiles, and then how to evaluate what this means in terms of safety of the tree, so that it doesn't collapse and kill someone.
Right, this is not something that a homeowner would just buy in order to check out one tree,
wouldn't recommend doing that, no. But there are experts even here in Oklahoma, so practically everywhere, that are focusing on that. And fortunately, there are people that really care about trees and get that education. And when these experts buy equipment like that, then it's really helpful.
Yeah.
First of all, it prevents accidents because they can identify trees that may be dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
Second, it saves money for the cities caring about urban trees because they know that some trees, for example, even they are obviously defective, they can still be kept in the city.
Mm-hmm.
So using that equipment properly really lowers the cost for caring about the urban green.
Okay, well, Frank, you know we have a few storms that come through here and a lot of wind, so we appreciate you bringing this technology and training our state arborists here in Oklahoma. Thank you.
I enjoy that. Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this video as part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on the OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.